Good morning. Those blue hoardings there on Arthur Street. I'm just by Monument / Bank Tube Station because that is the way into the Bank Capacity Upgrade Works. In January of this year, they closed the southbound Northern Line platform here at Bank. They're building a whole new one. They're putting in a whole new concourse, travelators, lifts, new station. A whole bunch of work is going on. It's due to open up in mid-May, so we're at the halfway point, and TfL said, do you want to come in for a sneak preview of what we've done so far? Yes, please. Come on.
Yes, I was first here back in 2018. That's when the tunnelling was underway. And just a few weeks ago in January, I visited the old platform at Bank before it closed for the last time ever. The current Northern Line closure is scheduled to last for 17 weeks. Mid-May is when TfL are saying it should open up again. And a small group of us, wearing our PPE of course, got to go down inside to see the works in progress where a huge amount had already been done in a short space of time.
We're starting by going into what would be the new Cannon Street entrance just here. This is where, if you look back on Google Street View, I mentioned this before, it used to be a McDonald's, but this is the way in around the back. We've come down a lot of steps, and this is the dramatic moment that we first go onto the new platform. Like, there it is. Ooh. Let's come down here. Hang on, we'll go for the super wide shot. Ready, 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 ready. Oh, nice. There's a thumbnail. In the briefing we had upstairs just now, I was the one, like the annoying school kid, asking the awkward questions. One of my awkward questions that I asked the team was, how wide is the new platform here? Because there's one at Euston on the Northern Line and there's one at Angel. I just wanted to know, is this the same width to you? Is it wider? Have you got a tape measure?
No, I have a tape
can
measure.
Can we measure it?
We can definitely get you the figure.
How wide is it?
I think the big thing to notice here, it is very wide in terms of a platform. But as Ian was explaining before, what defines the dimension really is the number of services that we have to take through the area. What obviously the biggest concern is creating space for customers, but certainly that's how we define the design.
Well, hang on a second, there's a hole. There's the platform. There's a hole with a platform under the platform. Kerry, why is that down there?
It's a platform invert carrying all the requirements for the utilities that we need to run the operational underground.
Is that on all new build stations and platforms, do you think?
On 90% of stations across the piece. You just won't notice.
Yeah, it's a platform invert.
Yeah, and it takes all of the utilities underneath the platforms that you stand on every day.
Let's ask it this way. Where's the existing southbound platform?
Just on the right-hand side.
That's what we're going through next. Yeah. Okay, so south is which way, sorry?
Is that
way.
Sorry, that's the north end.
That's the north end.
Yeah.
And that's the south end.
I'm losing my own direction.
And so trains will be coming this way on the right-hand running.
They'll be coming this right way.
This way, yeah. Like, follow my hand, people. This is going to be coming, chugging along this way like that. All right, okay, that now makes sense. All right. So we've got some new escalators here. There's three here behind me. These take you up to a mezzanine level, which turns through 90 degrees. And there's another three escalators, and that takes you up to the new Bank Cannon Street entrance. So six escalators at this end. Okay, and now the exciting part. We're walking through, after the escalators, into the moment of the old running tunnel. So, let's go this way. So this is I'm standing where the tracks used to be. The tracks were here, and if I just shuffle over this way, this is the old platform. So old platform, and until a few weeks ago, trains were running here. That's quite noisy, sorry. And then, just to give you context, the northbound tunnel, and you can see here they've opened up a new wide area here. The northbound tunnel is here. So let's do a 180. Existing northbound, old southbound, new southbound. You can see here they've started to install the new white panelling of the side of the platform. This is what it looks like behind. Morning. Hugh's back. Hugh, I'm very excited. We're clearly on the spot where the old running rails used to be.
That's right.
There's some old tiles up in the ceiling up there. What are the original City and South London Railway tiles?
Yeah, I believe so, yeah.
Maybe. And then this bit here, you can see the cast iron rings, the original tunnel. Again, dating back, what year would this have been?
1920s.
Yeah. That's the press office. Donuts.
This is the 125-year-old running tunnel.
If you're going to speak, Claire, I'll put you on camera. This is the 125-year-old running tunnel.
Yeah. going to tell you about that.
Okay.
Look at that, 125 years of dust.
What's happened?
125 years of dust.
You're not going to wash your hair now, are you?
So this is the City in South London lining, 1925, as you're probably familiar with. So this, I think this was extended up to Euston, 1925. And this is the section of abandoned railway that's going to be left behind at the end of the project that I'm sure you're probably likely to be wandering around at some time in the future. So we're basically following Princes Street. So you can see it's going straight up Princes Street and then turning the corner up to Princes Street. So that was the speed restriction on the corner. And we've basically smoothed out the new running tunnel. So it's to the left-hand side and it comes in, it's slightly longer, but it will be quicker actually getting physically into the station.
Whilst I'm fascinated to see what a wall panel looks like before it's put up, the area I'm in now is an interchange area, which is new. So the new running tunnel is there, the old one is there, and then behind me here is the link through. They're not running yet. I don't think they're going to be open in May. It will be later in the year. But travelators, woohoo, are coming to Bank Station. A pair of travelators, walking moveways, what are you going to call them? And that will take you through to the central line down there. So there's one side. There's the other side. Think of the connection at Waterloo to the Jubilee line. I'm told, by the way, the technical team here are saying I have to refer to it as a moving walkway, as the other name is, like a brand name. But I'm walking down the middle bit, the non-moving part, the in-between part of the moving walkway. Central line ahead.
Not one lost time injury
here. We're walking up some new escalators. There's three here at the end of the travelator, which takes you to the central line. I'm counting in my head, that's 9 new escalators we've seen so far. I'm told by Ian that there's another 3 somewhere. So there's 12 new escalators here at Bank on top of the escalators that were previously here. Now, I can't remember off the top of my head how many escalators there were, but Ian does reliably inform me that Bank... So this will be like a brand new pub quiz question for trivia. Bank will be the station with the most escalators on the network. Yes?
Yes.
Yes. I'll flash that number on screen now. I thought that was it. I thought we were on our way out. They're like, no, let's go for a walk down the track to see the other end. Heck yes. Just casually walking along the new bit of track in the new tunnel, bit of echo. We're going to go down and see where the junction was, where they broke it away from the original bit of the Northern Line. This is insanely cool. There's a video, 3-4 years old, where I first came down here when they were first constructing this. And there's a point where I came down some steps and down a shaft. That shaft is now above me. Above me, that leak, can you see? Thank goodness for the wide-angled lens. That shaft there has now all been completely filled in. And behind me there are the steps that I walked down in that video that takes you to Arthur Street. That's all now filled in. That's not being used anymore, but all the equipment and everything was brought down through this shaft. That is amazing to think that we were here and now it's got tracks and it's a proper running tunnel. And that way will be the end, which I think will wrap up the video, where we get to the bit where the southbound track splits away from the original southbound track. This is the furthest extent that we're allowed to come. So behind me here, you can see there's a light coloured wall here and there's a dark coloured wall there. Behind that dark coloured wall is the old bit of track, which is just going to be left there unused. This is looking south. Looking south, our train's going that way towards London Bridge, and then just further down is where they would have merged together, but it's not actually a junction. But the old tracks are just the other side of that wall. I'll try and get a zoom shot looking down the tunnel. I was going to wrap up back up on the surface where I started, but it's so incredible and amazing being down here, seeing it like this, that I'm just going to end the piece here. I'm standing on the new southbound Northern Line platform at Bank Station. Trains will be running from that way down that way sometime in mid-May. Wouldn't it be hilarious if it opened on the same day as the Crossrail Elizabeth Line? We'll find out, but your new Bank platform Northern Line is coming very, very soon.